Wakati wa maombi, wakati ni muombako, wakati mwingine anashusha baraka zake. Hata bila kumomba, hakika ananipenda.
Furaha yangu mimi ni kumsifu Bwana, aliye mwamba wangu, ninajivunia kila siku.
Anichoki
yeye ananiongoza kupambana
na magumu
yote yasiyowezekana kwangu. Furaha yangu mimi ni kumsifu Bwana, aliye mwamba wangu, ninajivunia kila siku. Yeye ananiongoza kupambana
na magumu
yote yasiyowezekana kwangu.
Bye. I am the handmaid of the Lord. Let it be done to me as you have said. Today, the congregation of the Franciscan Sisters of the Immaculate Conception of the Holy Mother of God joined the entire church in celebrating this day, this great day of the solemnity of the Immaculate Conception of the Blessed Virgin Mary, our patroness, through a gesture of gratitude to God for his love and the gift of vocation of our 3 year beautiful, enthusiastic, and mission set sisters, Sister Jacqueline Ache Onyango, Sister Lydia Nafula Wafula, and Sister Mary Nagila Wanyama, expressed through the first temporary profession to consecrated life in this Eucharistic celebration. The profession of temporary vows to consecrated life is an act whereby one freely commits oneself to God in the presence of the church and the congregation, and explicitly promises to live in community according to the rule and the life and life of the brothers and sisters of the order of the Third Order Regular of St. Francis and the constitutions of the congregation. The sisters in particular binds herself to keep the biblical concepts of chastity, poverty, and obedience. And be received, I am the handmaid of the Lord. Let it be done to me as you have said. These words of Mary have been the source of inspiration to our 3 young sisters. Today, who are about to proclaim their yes to the Lord through the SFIC way of life. Mary's yes is most profound, a gesture of total emptying of herself to the holy will of God. Her yes became salvation as the mother of our Savior. Like Mary, our 3 sisters are being inspired by the person of Mary in their life and experience of God's love in a unique way. They have responded to this loving invitation of God by committing themselves to follow Christ through the SFIC way of life for the love of God and his mission. We praise and thank God for the gift of vocation of our dear sisters, Sister Jacqueline Ache Onyango, Sister Lydia Nafula Wafula, and Sister Mary Nagila Wanyama. We pray for them that this occasion and celebration will always be an inspiration in their daily response and faithfulness to the love of God in their life. We congratulate Sisters Jacqueline Ache Onyango, Sister Lydia Nafula Wafula, and Sister Mary Nagila Wanyama for their courage to imitate our Mother Mary, the model of our religious calling. We pray that their yes today will be a lifelong yes to the Lord. Happy celebration to us all. Mary conceived without origin of sin, pray for us. Tsunami God.
Apologies from a superior of the Capuchins, Father Paul Silla, who was to celebrate this Mass, but he has delegated me to do it on his behalf. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Time and again, we keep on wronging God and wronging one another. Let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, our Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Thank you.
God, who by the Immaculate Conception of the Blessed Virgin prepared a worthy dwelling for your Son, grant, we pray, that as you preserve her from every stain by virtue of the death of your Son, which you foresaw, so through her intercession, we too may be cleansed and admitted to your presence. O Lord, who have inspired these our sisters, Jacqueline, Lydia, and Mary, with the resolve to follow Christ more closely, grant them, we pray, a blessed end to the journey they now begin, so that they may be found worthy to offer you a perfect gift of loving service, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. And I hid myself. He said, "Who told you that you are naked? Have you eaten of the tree of which I commanded you not to eat? The man said, the woman whom you gave to be with me, she gave me fruits of the tree and I ate. Then the Lord God said to the woman, what is it that you have done? The woman said, the serpent beguiled me and I ate. The Lord God said to the serpent, because you have done this, cursed are you above all cattle and above all wild animals. Upon your belly you shall go, and thus shall you eat all the days of your life. I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your seed and her seed. He shall bruise your head, and you shall bruise his heel. The man called his wife's name Eve, because she was the mother of all living. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
That we should be holy and blameless before him. He everything this made us in love to be his son through Jesus Christ, according to the purpose of his will, to the praise of his glorious grace, which he freely bestowed on us in the beloved. In him, according to the purpose of him who accomplishes all things, according to the counsel of his will, we who first hoped in Christ have been destined and appointed to live for the praise of his glory. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us rise for gospel affirmation.
In her mind, what sort of greeting this might be. And the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give to him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." And Mary said to the angel, "How will this be, since I do not know man?" And the angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God. And behold, your kinswoman Elizabeth, in her old age, has also conceived a son. And this is the sixth month with her, who was called barren. For with God, nothing will be impossible." And Mary said, "Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. Let it be to me according to your word." And the angel departed from her. the gospel of the Lord. Let us now proceed and witness to the temporary procession rite. May Colon Sister Marian Comelo, SFIC Novice Mistress, to present the candidate.
I now call Novice Jacqueline Acheng Onyango.
Lord, you have called me, here I am.
Novice Lydia Nafula Wafula.
Lord, you have called me, here I am.
Novice Mary Nagila Wanyama.
Lord, you have called me, here I am.
Beloved daughters, you have listened to the word of God. The Christian community is gathered here this morning to pray with you and for you. What do you ask of God and of His Holy Church?
We ask for His grace to consecrate ourselves to Him, to follow His will. In imitation of Jesus Christ and His Blessed Mother, in the religious community of the Franciscan Sisters of the Immaculate Conception, of the Holy Mother of God, and to persevere in this vocation.
SFIC Sisters, please stand up.
We pray, praise, and thank God, the source of all being, eternal Word and Holy Spirit. Amen.
Let us all visit and let us listen to the homily of Father Robert Sell.
Mungu ni mwema, kila wakati. Basi kama nilivyotangulia kusema kwamba leo ni siku ya kipekee kwa sababu tunashuhudia masista wetu watatu wakisema ndio mbele yake Mwenyezi Mungu. Na ili mambo haya yote yatimie ni Mungu ameyawezesha. Basi tayarisha mkono wako vizuri, tumpigie Mungu makofi. Moja, mbili, asante. Na pia ili siku hii ifanikiwe vizuri, Mungu ametupatia zawadi ya wazazi. Wazazi hawa watoto wao walipoambia wanataka kwenda kumtumikia Mwenyezi Mungu, wamekufika kwao hapa, unanionyesha kwamba wamekubali. Hivyo basi wazazi, tunawashukuru. Hata hao watarisheni makofi. Moja. Asanteni sana. Bila hawa warembo watatu hatungekuwa hapa leo hii. Hata mimi singepata nafasi ya kuwa hapa leo. Hivyo basi hata nyinyi kwa kufuata mfano wa Mama Maria tunawashukuru. Hata hao tuwape makofi. Moja. Tena asanteni sana. Today we are celebrating the solemnity of Immaculate Conception. And for us to celebrate this feast, something went wrong somewhere. And who caused this is Satan. When you watch Nigerian movies, they are always saying, Satan is a liar. Satan is a deceiver. It's in the Bible. Satan is a liar. He is a deceiver. And Satan has a scheme. He knows how to tempt human beings. And that is what we have in the first reading. He tempted Eve. His plan is to identify a desire inside a human being. And then he will make you doubt the word of God. And thirdly, he will deceive you. Finally, he will make you disobey God. And that is what we call temptation. That scheme of Satan. But God, from the beginning, had a plan with human beings. He wanted to save humanity. And that is why he also came with his plan to defeat the devil. And his plan is, God is not saying that temptation is bad. He knows that temptation to every Christian, to every human being, should be an opportunity to do good. It is an opportunity. The choice is yours. So it is upon you. Satan uses temptation. That is his only primary weapon to destroy you. But God will use the same temptation to develop you. And this is what we saw in the first reading. Through Eve, sin entered into the world. But through men, God prepared her from a long time ago. Because all of us, we are born of the original sin. Each one of us. But only Mary got the sanctifying grace. God was preparing her. She was born out of this sin. And that is why Mary today is called Immaculate. But God has interest to all of us, and that is why through his plan, he gave us our mother Mary, who was to born a child named Jesus. Yes, he gave us a child, Jesus. And since the coming of Christ, we can also attain grace through baptism. We, through other sacraments, we can attain grace. And all this came because our mother said yes. Our mother said yes. And the words she's using today are, I am the handmaid of the Lord. Let it be done to me as you have said. I am the handmaid. That is the word that touches me most. Handmaid, I am a servant. Let it be done to me as you have said. The Bible asks, who is the greatest? Whoever wants to be great must be a servant. My dear sisters and brothers, if you want to be great, you must be a servant. Mary accepted to be a servant. And by accepting God's call, she became great, full of grace. My dear sisters, as you profess today, accept to be called servants, okay? Leo tunasherekea hii sherehe ya Mama Maria, kwamba ni yeye ndiye alizaliwa pasipo dhambi ya asili. Mary Kende, Emmanuel, kaonge ni maraji mal, kuhu. Kende, maraji, mal, kuhu. Najwa kijaluo ni gritu, kama gritu. Kwa hivyo, nimefanya milimu kisoma hili, maneno ya Biblia yake sawa sawa. Sasa maraji marukodi ndio dhambi ya asili. Hiyo ndio dhambi ya asili. Mary alizaliwa pasipo na dhambi ya asili, na ni kwa sababu Mungu, ulikuwa ni mpango wa Mungu kwamba Maria atuokoe. Gabrieli malaika alipompelekea salamu, tumeona Maria amepiga magoti na kumwambia Mungu kwamba mimi ni mjakazi wako, nitendewe kama ulivyosema. Hivyo basi tunawaambia hawa masista wetu watatu ambao leo wanaweka nadhiri zao za kwanza, kwamba mjue kile mnacho hapa leo ni kumwambia Mungu kwamba mnataka kuwa wajakazi wake, sio kuwa mabosi, ni kuwa wajakazi. Wajakazi. Unajua mara nyingi ukiona mapadri hawa, ukiona masista hawa wanakaa kifalme sivyo? Lakini mpango ambao Mungu anao kwenu ni kwamba muwe wajakazi. Wajakazi. Na unapotamani sana kuwa sister, huwa uko na unyenyekevu mwingi sana, sivyo? Kila mara, jana huyu sister Mary alisema kwamba kila mara anapokuwa na shaka juu ya maisha haya anakumbuka ofisi yake. Hata mimi pia ninapokuwa na mashaka nakumbuka ofisi yake, jinsi nilivyokuwa mnyenyekevu. Lakini kuna mara nyingine inakuja mpaka unakuta tu umefanya nini, umechoka. Maisha yanaweza choka. Nakumbuka nilipokuwa natamani kuwa padri miaka mingi iliyopita, tulikuwa tuna tulikuwa na walezi wazungu. Wazungu ndio walikuwa wanatuangalia sisi, wanakaa huko nyuma, sisi tunakaa mbele. Wazungu wana mabevu makubwa, akikuangalia hivi anafuraha, lakini wewe unafikiri amekasirika. Sasa mimi nilisema natamani kuwa padri, lazima nifanye chochote kile ambayo inanifanya niwe padri. Hakuna mtu alikuwa anatembea kama mtakatifu kama mimi nikiwa na ofisi yake. Hivi ndio ilikuwa natembea. Nikifika altarini nilipiga, hata kama niliyo mfungu ananiangalia, ni nani anaweza kunifukuza nikishafanya namna hii? Hakuna. Hakuna. Lakini baada ya miaka michache nimekuta nimechoka. Siku hizi hata nikienda altarini naenda. Hata leo Fadha Shumira amenikumbusha, Fadha unaenda kanisani kama mimi. Nikifika hata kwa jina la Baba. Kwa sababu ya kuchoka. Mafadha wanachoka, masista pia wanachoka, wamama wa CW pia wanachoka. Ukitaka kuwa CWS unafanya bidii, CMA. Ukitaka kwaya unafanya bidii, lakini baada ya muda unachoka. Sasa mimi nawatahadharisha, leo nimekuja niwape nguvu mpya, uamke tena. Kumbuka kule ulipokuwa, vile ulivyokuwa ukitamani. Hata wanandoa pia wanachoka. Mwaka wa kwanza mnapokutana na mpenzi wako, si unaona kuna furaha sana? Hata uwezi kula kama hayuko, hata lazima umpigie simu, Baba Dennis uko wapi? Chakula kinapoa. Baada ya miaka miwili upendo umekwisha, unalarua unalala, una wasiwasi. Sasa hiyo maisha ni kwa mwanadamu yoyote. Na ndio kwa sababu nimekuja upate nguvu mpya. Ukumbuke miaka ile ya kwanza mlipokuwa mnakutana. Ukumbuke wakati ule ulipokuwa na wito wako unataka kumtumikia Mungu. Hapo ulipokuwa ukimwambia sister, "Yes sister, I want to serve Jesus Christ." Siku hizi unamwambia, "Sister, what a love." Hata mafaa. Akwambia enda. Mimi kusoma hii maneno ya Maria ilinisaidia. Hata Father Paul maisubiri akishashindwa huko kote anatafuta tuseme enda tukito sawa baba naye maana hata sijamaliza enda ukabali sawa naye natembea tu. So unyenyekevu. Na ndio kwa sababu Maria anapopokea hii anasema kwamba mimi sio boss. Mimi ni mjakazi. Anapiga magoti na anamwambia Mungu, "Nitendewe vile ulivyo nena." Mara nyingi nimesema hapa Mungu anatumia hawa viongozi wenu, viongozi wetu kama sauti yao. Tulifundishwa the voice of the superior is the voice of God. That is the sweeter heart to swallow. Voice of the superior, the voice of God. Gani? Ukiwa na ofisi yake ni rahisi kukubali hiyo maneno? Maneno. Kisha fika huko juu. But mimi na wakukusha sawa sawa, sisi tume Mungu ametuchagua ili tuwe wahudumu. Our work is to serve. So we serve God by serving others. The world today defines greatness in terms of titles, prestige, positions. And in our self-serving culture, with its me-first mentality, acting like a servant is not a popular concept. We don't want to act like servants. We don't want. Jesus, however, measured greatness in terms of service and not status. God determines your greatness by how many people you serve, not how many people serve. So, my dear sisters, from here, just have that hunger to serve your fellow sisters, to serve the people of God. That is what He has called you to do. Service. Hakuna kitu. Hapo kuchagua uende ulale kwa room, hapo kuchagua uende ukawatch movies, hapo kuchagua uende ukastarehe, lakini amekuchagua kumtumikia. And even that's why we say that people always, the case is the nature of a human being. We want to be leaders. If I'm not a leader, I cannot stay in that place. But be like Jesus. To be like Jesus is to be a servant. How can you know that you have the heart of a servant? You can tell by what they do. Jesus answers. So real servants make themselves available to serve. If you want to know that you are a servant, you will always make yourself available. Make yourselves available. Mother Mary made herself available. Nasema, mimi ni mjakazi wako, nitendewe nilivyonena. Servants don't fill up their time with other pursuits that would limit their availability. They want to be ready to jump into service. They are like soldiers. What is it? Iko nini nifanye? Sister, kazi gani imekulemea hapo tukusaidie? Hiyo ndio roho ambayo takana uwe nayo. Sister Jackie, iko kazi gani? Lydia, iko kazi gani? Sure, man. ukiamka tu ukimaliza sala iko kazi gani na walemea hapa mimi jana niliosha vyombo na mimi amekaa tu ananiangalia mimi siyo kiote mimi ndio nimepika chai bona yeye afanye chochote wewe amka tofauti hiyo mitai nataka kuwapikia hii wiki sitaki kutumia hiyo tulio stahili fanya ukifanya hivyo pia utapigwa vita sikio hebu wewe ndio unafanya kwamba wewe unajua sana hapa baada kuwa focus focus wito wako wewe ndio Mungu amekuita anajua amekuita na sauti zinaanza tu hapa mahali tuko watu wawili tuko watu watatu hapo ndio sauti zinaanza then you go outside yeah so today the question you should be asking yourself will you be available for God anytime? Will you be available if God needs you? Can God mess up your plans without you becoming resentful? Being a servant means giving up a right to control your schedule and allowing God to interrupt it wherever He needs to. So let God control your program. Let God control your program. Number two, real servants. Pay attention to the needs. Pay attention to the need. As I was talking with Sister Lydia, she didn't want to see sick people. Sick people. She got scared with them. But your sister tells her, go and work in the hospital. Go and work on the hospital. Will I manage? Then she prayed. After some few weeks, she got used to it. Yani nikitu wapa nikuwa maona, siwezi, hata mimi sahi, mambo ya hospital, siwezani nayo. Lakini kumbe baada ya kuomba Mungu akapenda. Unaona eh? Kuna kitu ambacho unaweza fikiria iwezekani. Omba Mungu. Pay attention to the need. Pay attention to the need. Real servants do every task with equal dedication. Nguvu zako zote tumia kumtumikia Mungu. Real servants are faithful to their ministry. Be faithful. Servants finish their tasks. They fulfill their responsibilities. They keep their promises and complete their commitments. Those are the real servants. Real servants maintain low profile. Servants don't promote or call attention to themselves. Fanya kazi yako, enda zako. Sasa, usingojee. Hata siku hilo umepika supu mzuri. Sio utembee tembee. Usikie watu wanasema kitu, wewe unazunguka. Unangojea Sister Mary aseme chochote, aseme. Unangojea Sister Mary aseme, aseme. Inabidi sasa wewe ulize. Vipi? Hiyo supu mmeionaje? Hiyo ndio kusika te. Attention. Wewe pika uende bwana. Pika uende zako. Wakisema asante, sawa sawa. Wakinyamaza pia ni sawa? Sawa. Huyo ndio real sapa. They maintain low profile. Nataka nyinyi mumaintain low profile. Sawa sawa. Wewe wanyenyekevu. Wewe wanyenyekevu. Jinsi mimi nilivyo mnyenyekevu. Tumona tu yule jamaa ananipigia yeye hata kuja. Na mimi pia nilikuwa nangoja tu asije. Kwa sababu vile nimetembea na nyinyi nilitaka lazima nifanye hii sherehe. Mungu asante kwa kuja. Sasa haya yote. Nilipokuwa pale tena kuja hapa Yule ameniambia kule kaona Shumila hapa. Shumila ni wa kansila. Nikasema sasa Shumila tunakuja kufanya nini? Nikamwambia Shumila now that you are here as a kansila. Now we have to celebrate this mass. Shumila kaniambia sewe. You are the one who is delegated. Nikanifanya sitaki. Nilikuwa na furaha kabisa. Unaona? Mungu alikuwa amepanga. Mimi ndio nisome hivi. Asante ndugu kwa Shumila. Sasa hiyo ndio real support. You are ready. Ningedelegatiwa ni sawa. If they don't delegate me, it is also okay. Yeah. I was prepared for it, but at last, God, he told me from yesterday, the way I'm seeing things, you are the one who is going to celebrate it. Yeah. So, nashukuru Mungu kwa kunipatia hiyo nafasi. Now, you are part and parcel of myself. Sio eh? Mungu awabariki sana. Mungu awabariki. Na haya yote yatafanyika kama tukiwa watu wa sala. We have to be a prayerful people. My sisters, love prayers. Mpende sana. Sasa, msichoke. Na hiyo sala mnasikia tunasema, sala sio rahisi, sala ni ngumu. Hakuna kitu ngumu kama sala. Maisha ya kusali. Nikitoka, nilikuwa natoka Homa Bay. Naenda Kisii. Ni mwendo wa dakika 50. Mwendo wa dakika 50. Na mimi napenda sana kusikiza muziki taratibu. Unajua ukishafika umri kama hii yangu sasa, sio umri ya mzee sana na sio kijana sana, upendi ngoma za haraka haraka kitu kelele. Napenda tu kitu naenda pole pole. Rumba kama madilu sisi namna hii inagonga pole pole Sasa wakati niko kwa hiyo gari, sista mmoja akaja akasema Father, tunaomba lift, tuko na Father Moses. It's a true story, mwende kumuulize Father Moses kisa. Yeye pia anapenda rumba. Tumekaa na yeye. Mimi nimekaa kwa driving seat. Sister akaja akabisha. Akasema anataka lift. Sister anaenda wapi? Anaenda Kisii. Mwambia sawa sister ingia. Sister alipoingia wakati Father Moses anachokora chokora mitambo. Na mimi nataka kuondoka. Sister akasema, Father, tusali rosari. Rosari. Itaisha sanga. Hapo Moses, nimesikia tu huko. Na mimi kwenye roho yangu pia nasema, jamani sister, si umeomba lift. Si utulie. Kipelepele mchani. Tulia. Sista gari si lako. Nimejawa na hasira nyingi sana. Sista gari tulia. Lakini, sista aliposema, Father tusali rosari, hakutaka majadiliano. Ya kusema, Father tusali rosari. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Sisi huku tunapigana. Moses amekasirika na mimi nimekasirika. Sisi anaendelea, hey Mary, if you don't bless the Lord is with you. Tulikuja tukashika moto wa rosari tukiwa kwenye tendo la tano. Ndio Mungu, kumbe vile sister anasali na Mungu anaregesha hasira yetu chini pole pole. Nafasi ya tatu tukaingia kwa sala nzuri, na uwezi ingia pia kama ulikuwa umejaa na Roho Mtakatifu, unaingia pia hivyo. kodi meno wakoni. Nilipofika ya tangu. Robati diyo, holy Mary, mother of God. Ninakwambia sasa sala ilikuwa imechata. Nakwambia Mungu, endelea. Kuanza kusali ni gumu, bado ukisali kuna nguvu ndani ya sala. Hivyo basi jamani, ndugu na dada zangu, nawaomba muwe watu wa sala. Mkiwa sala, mtashinda majaribu mengi. Haya ambayo mnasikia yanatusumbua. Leo Hawa wataweka nadhiri tatu mbele yake Mwenyezi Mungu. Wataapa wenyewe kwa midomo yao kwamba wanataka kuwa wafukara, wanataka kuwa wasichana wa kumtii sauti ya Mungu, na pia wanataka kuishi kwa usafi kamili, usafi wa moyo. Hivyo basi kwa hao wanajua hayo, nadhiri ya ufukara, maana yake hawa wanaamua leo kwamba hawatakuwa na mali yoyote, hatakuwa na mali. Hata ukimwona amekuja na gari kubwa na gari nyumbani, sio yake, ni gari ya shirika. Huyu hatakuwa na account. Kwa hivyo hivi mnavyomwona bado anawategemea, bado anatutegemea. Akija nyumbani, mwambie sister, wewe tuombee. Chukua hiyo, rudi kanisani. Sina hii, sawa sawa, tutakusaidia. Na huyu, kwenye familia yako sasa hivi kutakuwa na mabadiliko makubwa, kwa sababu kuna mtu wa kukuombea kila wakati. Ukiangalia vizuri, huyu Jacqueline. Jacqueline kineno vete lu. Ponya lu vitu pesa lika. Huyu Jacqueline ameza kwa kama pesa kati. Na ispoke ma. Kako rungi umila gila mapele. Watu wamekuja tu vizuri nyumbani kiangalia huyu. Sini kitu mzuri tu. Mali mzuri. Sindio? Hata huyu Lydia. Mama. Lydia huyu, kama sasa tu watu wamekuja vizuri, zinaweza kuwa tu pesa vizuri. Mary, hebu smile kidogo akuone. Hata huyo Mary, unajua Mungu anachagua wale wazuri wazuri. Angalia, hata ukipiga tu jicho upande huu, angalia. Yesu anajua kufanya nini, anajua kutaka. Hivyo basi wewe umesema kwamba hiyo mali ambayo imekuja, wewe ndio umetoa sadaka ya kwanza. Umesema kwamba mimi sijali. Kuna wazazi wengi wamekataza watoto wao kuja kutumikia Mwenyezi Mungu. Wewe umesema wacha uende, na leo umekuja mwenyewe kumtoa huyu mtoto kama sadaka kanisani. Huyu Mungu anaona moyo wako. Na Mungu sahihi akupatie namna hii, ameanza kukumiminia baraka. Hivyo basi unapokuwa kwenye misa hii, watu si unaona wakileta sadaka zao za mbuzi wanavyofurahi. Leo furahi mama Lydia kwamba mtoto wangu na kutoa, sio kwa kafara, lakini na kutoa kwa Mungu, kwa Mungu. Na Mungu ameanza tayari kuibariki familia, kwa sababu hawa wanawaombea usiku na mchana. Pia wataweka nadhiri ya utii. Nadhiri ya utii watakayoweka ni ya kusikia sauti yake Mwenyezi Mungu kupitia kwa mkubwa wao na kupitia pia kwa dada zao wengine wakubwa. Kwa hivyo yeye anaweza kutuma mahali popote, iwe ni mahali pazuri ama mahali pabaya. Juzi tumesikia yule fadha alitumwa huko Kameruni. Unaona hii maisha yetu. Hivyo ndugu yalivyo. Unaweza shukulia tu. Sister Mary atasimama hapa aseme, Sister Mary, Kameruni. Mwate kwa hende. Mungu anajua. Mungu anajua. Hiyo ndio maisha yetu. Hiyo ndio maisha yetu. Na popote atakapotumwa, usione kwamba umeonewa. Ah, ni sauti ya Mungu. Yule kijana ameenda kule amekufa kama mfiadini. Mungu anaibariki familia kupitia kwa haya. Hivyo basi sisi tuko hapa. Hata Yesu aliamua kwamba mimi nitafanya mapenzi ya baba yangu. Hata ilimaanisha kufanya nini? Kufa. Lakini baada ya siku ya tatu nitafufuka. Roho ya yule padri imefufuka kitambo. Hivyo basi hata nyinyi msikatae wito wa wakubwa zenu. Wito wa Mungu. Ya tatu ni usafi wa moyo. Usafi wa moyo. Hamtaolewa. Mambo ya Bwana sahau. Hata mimi mambo ya mimi nilisahau. Nilisahau. Bwana fadha moja mtaliano anasema, Robert, you know, if you don't have a wife, naomba yes, Father, I don't have. Your Bible should always be here. Your Bible is your wife. Mzee anapiga kelele hata bali kuna wake. Anasema, your Bible is your wife. And it's true. Hata wewe, let your Bible be your wife. And you have family. Wakati niko na kwamba wazuri kwa sukuma na mna hii, wana hii nini ni husband. Kwa hivyo mambo ya wanaume, sahau, wewe na Mungu wako. Hivyo basi, sisi tunawashukuru tena, muendelee kila mara kusikiliza maneno haya ya Mama Maria. Kuwa na nadhiri ya kwanza, si kitu. Kuwa na nadhiri ya inaitwa ya nini? Ya mwisho. Ama ni ya daima. It's nothing. Final profession. To be a formator. Nothing. Hakuna kitu. Tusikia Sister Moni Avuri. Nothing. Formator. To be delegated as a priest. Hakuna kitu. Guru kabisa. What God wants is your heart of service. Be ready to serve. Hilo ndio Mungu anataka. Uwe tayari kumtumikia. Usiwe mtu wa kuangalia vyeo. Ukiwa mdogo namna hiyo, tumikie Mwenyezi Mungu. These are the words today. Aya ya 7. Let it be done as you have said. Let it be done so. Wazazi, hata nini mmesema, nini pia ni watumishi wa Mungu, wacha Mungu afanye mambo yake, mambo yake. Hivyo basi nawashukuru wote ambao tuko hapa kuwashuhudia. Leo ni siku ya furaha kwa sababu Mungu anatimiza kazi yake ndani ya hawa madada watatu. Nataka kuona nyuso za furaha, nyuso za vigelegele, kumwambia Mungu tunatoa sadaka iliyo safi. Atukuzwe Baba, Mwana na Roho Mtakatifu.
Asante sana Father Robert kwa umetupewa ujumbe tamu mzuri na changamoto kwa maisha yetu wa Kristo wote, wa padri na watawa. Asante sana Father. Sasa tunakaribisha Roho Mtakatifu. Tafadhali tunapiga magoti kama unaweza, kama hawezi simama tu vizuri. Sister Maureen, our Anna Soma Katiba Maneno kutoka Katiba ya shirika letu. Alafu wanabishada yetu wetu wanasimama mbele ya Padre Robert. Alafu anauliza maswali wengi kutoka juu ya maisha yetu kwa shirika letu.
I read you from SFIC Constitution, Spiritual Basis, Chapter 1, Lines 14 to 34. As sisters who, by religious profession, have been admitted in this congregation, will seek themselves in the gospel and in the way St. Francis lived it. After the example of the sisters who preceded them, this will open their eyes to the needs of their times and of their surroundings, and will teach them to search for ways to alleviate these needs. According to the tradition of the congregation, they will give special attention to the underprivileged sectors of society. For the sisters are called to heal the wounded, to bind up those who are bruised, and to reclaim the erring. In the first constitution and rule of the congregation, the spirit of the members should be a spirit of simplicity, submission, love, and penance. The sisters continue to live this spirit in the here and now. The end of the reading.
Ningependa kualika Sister Jacqueline, Sister Lija and Sister Manny. Simama sana mbele ya Father Robert.
Beloved daughters, you have already been consecrated to God's service through the sacrament of baptism. Are you resolved to unite yourselves more closely to Him through a new form of life as vowed religious?
Yes, I am.
In your desire to follow Christ perfectly, are you resolved to live a life of celibate chastity for the sake of the kingdom, to embrace voluntary poverty and evangelical obedience according to the spirit and charism of the Franciscan Sisters of the Immaculate Conception of the Holy Mother of God?
By God's grace I am.
May the Almighty God grant you His grace to fulfill what you resolve.
Amen.
Let us pray. Loving and merciful God, look upon your servant sisters, Jacqueline, Lydia, and Mary, who are resolved to dedicate their life to you by making profession of the evangelical counsels in the presence of your church today. Mercifully grant that their manner of life may bring glory to your name and further your loving plan of redemption. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Now the main celebrant blesses the seniors, veils, and rule, and life, and the constitution.
Lord our God, we ask you to bless these religious veils, the insignia of the congregation, and the rule and life and constitutions, Let them be lasting signs to our newly professed sisters for their consecration to you and of their belonging to the congregation of Franciscan Sisters of the Immaculate Conception of the Holy Mother of God. Help Sisters Jacqueline, Lydia, and Mary, who will use these signs to remain always faithful to their consecration to Christ. Thus may these signs be blessed in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Hail Mary. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Mission Superior Sister Mary from Darina sits near the main celebrant. The novice kneels in front of the Mission Superior as she pronounces her vows, placing her hands on the palm of the Mission Superior.
I, Sister Jacqueline Achieng Onyango, declare my willingness to live as a religious in the congregation of the Franciscan Sisters of the Immaculate Conception of the Holy Mother of God. I therefore promise to you, God, my Almighty Father, in the hands of Sister Adriana Toni, General Superior, represented by Sister Meli Prondarina, Mission Superior, to follow the gospel of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, in the spirit and after the example of Saint Francis. I vow for 1 year chastity, poverty, and obedience, according to the rule and life of the brothers and sisters of the Third Order Regular of St. Francis and the constitutions of this congregation.
Sister Jacqueline Achieng Onyango, on behalf of Sister Maria Lourdes, on behalf of Sister Diane Tony, our General Superior, I accept your profession. I declare that you are accepted in our community, the Congregation of the Franciscan Sisters of the Immaculate Conception of the Holy Mother of God for 1 year. Sister Jacqueline, accept this veil as a sign of your commitment and fidelity with our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Sister Jacqueline, accept this as a SMKC insignia, a sign of unity and solidarity with all the sisters wherever they are, and a reminder of our spirit and charism. Receive this rule and life of the brothers and sisters of the Third Order Regular of St. Francis of Assisi and the SFIC Constitution, which you are bound to read, live, and obey. Give yourself wholeheartedly to Christ the Lord and faithfully witness in your whole life what you learn.
Amen.
Our General Superior, I accept your profession. I declare that you are accepted in our community, the Congregation of the Franciscan Sisters of the Immaculate Conception of the Holy Mother of God for 1 year. Accept this veil as a sign of your commitment and fidelity to our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Accept this SFIC insignia, a sign of unity and solidarity
with all the sisters wherever they are, and a reminder of our spirit and charism.
Amen.
Sister Lydia, receive this rule and life of the brothers and sisters of the Third Order Regular of St. Francis and the SFIC constitutions, which you are bound to read, live, and obey. Give yourself wholeheartedly to Christ the Lord and faithfully witness in your whole life what you learn.
Amen. In the spirit and after the example of St. Francis, I vow for 1 year chastity, poverty, and obedience, according to the rule and life of the brothers and sisters of the Third Order Regular of St. Francis and the constitutions of this congregation.
Sister Mary Nandila Manyama, on behalf of Sister Adriana Toni, our General Superior, I accept your profession. I declare you are accepted in our community, the Congregation of the Franciscan Sisters of the Immaculate Conception of the Holy Mother of God, for 1 year. Sister Mary,
accept this way as a sign of your commitment and fidelity to our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Accept this SFIC insignia, a sign of unity and solidarity with all the sisters, wherever they are, and a reminder of our spirit and charism.
Amen.
Sister Mary, receive this rule and life of the brothers and sisters of the Third Order Regular of St. Francis and the SFIC Constitution, which you are bound to read, live, and obey. Give yourself wholeheartedly to Christ the Lord and faithfully witness in your whole life what you learn.
Amen.
Franciscan women all the days of your life, as you continue to discern your desire to belong forever to the SFIC fold, and that we also strengthen and support each other in our resolution to live out joyfully the spirit and charism of the congregation in responding to the signs of the times.
The SFIC sisters welcome the newly professed sisters with a holy kiss of peace. The Mission Superior, Mission Board, and all the SFIC sisters and the parents. The others will do that after the celebration.
Thank you.
In her Immaculate Conception, Mary is revealed as the second Eve. She is God's new beginning for our race. As we honor her today, let us join her in prayer to our Father and Creator. For every petition we pray, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Church may grow towards the perfection of Mary, our destiny and our hope. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That through prayer and penance, the world may enter an age of peace, which is triumph of Mary's heart. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That Mary, who is full of grace, may help us on our pilgrimage. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our country, Kenya, and those who hold public office, may they work for the well-being of our people and commit themselves to serve with justice and integrity, where forgiveness, peace, reconciliation, and compassion abound. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our congregation, may she remain faithful and one in Christ, and make present God's compassionate love, especially to the poor and the needy sectors of our society. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For sisters Jacqueline, Lydia, and Mary, may they continue to be witnesses to the goodness and faithfulness of God in their community, ministry, and prayer. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the presence of sisters Jacqueline, Lydia, and Mary, that the Lord may reward them more abundantly for offering their daughters to the service of God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all the dead, especially the father of Sister Jacqueline and all our co-sisters, may rejoice forever in the company of Mary and the saints. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father and Creator, hear us as we pray with the Immaculate Ever Virgin Mary, chosen before the world was made to be the mother of Jesus, your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Sasa ni wakati wa kujitolea vipaji.
Thank you.
sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the grace and the glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his church.
Graciously accept the saving sacrifice which we offer you, O Lord, on the solemnity of the Immaculate Conception of the Blessed Virgin Mary, and grant that as we profess her, on account of your prevenient grace, to be untouched by any stain of sin, so through her intercession, we may be delivered from all our faults through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you preserved the most blessed Virgin Mary from all stain of original sin, so that in her, endowed with the rich fullness of your grace, you might prepare a worthy mother for your Son and signify the beginning of the Church, his beautiful bride without spot or wrinkle. She, the most pure Virgin, was to bring forth a Son, the innocent Lamb who would wipe away our offenses. You blessed her above all others to be for your people an advocate of grace and a model of holiness. And so in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you and with joy we proclaim. Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate this mystery. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world. Save us, Savior of the world. For by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance in your elect, especially the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, Saint Francis, Saint Clare, and all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence with life and very time.
May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis our Pope, John Cardinal Jewel, our Bishop Kamau Isaac Sirianni, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy and entire people you have gained for your own.
Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered through and through our life. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you as they are passing from this planet, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Formed by divine teaching, we dare pray, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever."
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
With joy and love, let's we share the peace of Christ.
Lord who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are invited into this banquet.
Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter my room, but only say, Lord, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Thank you.
pray. May the mysteries we have received fill us with joy, O Lord, and grant that by their power, these your servants, Sisters Jacqueline, Lydia, and Mary, may faithfully fulfill the duties of the religious life they have begun, and may offer you willing service through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us all be seated. May I request the Uniprofess sisters to please collect their flowers.
What is it?
May I request Mr. Wafula, on behalf of the three families, to say something.
Asante sana. Mungu mwema.
Kila wakati.
Kila wakati.
Mungu ni mwema.
Mungu ni mwema. Naomba kutumia lugha nzuri. Hiyo nyingine ya wenyewe. Nilipo hapa na furahi unachofanya. Siku ya leo ni siku ambayo mimi nimeisubiri kwa hamu na ghamu. Na nikasema kwamba Mwenyezi Mungu aweze kutufikia siku ya leo ili tufike hapa tuweze kusherehekea mabinti hawa ambao kidogo wameweza kufurahisha nyoyo zetu, wameweza kumfurahisha Mwenyezi Mungu, wameweza kujifurahisha. Niwapigie makofi tafadhali. Labda nitaanza kwa kumshukuru Mwenyezi Mungu. Unapokiti kutafakari jinsi ulivyoumbwa, jinsi unavyopendeza, jinsi chochote unachokifanya. Hata siku ya leo yeye ndiye ametuwezesha kufika mahali hapa. Kila mmoja ana kila sababu ya kumshukuru Mwenyezi Mungu. Mimi hapa kwa niaba yenu ninaomba kumwambia Mwenyezi Mungu wimbo mfupi. Nitakushukuru Mungu, nitakushukuru Mungu kwa kuwa nimeumbwa. Nimeumbwa kwa jinsi ya ajabu, ajabu ya kutisha. Nitakushukuru Mungu, nitakushukuru Mungu kwa kuwa nimeumbwa. Nimeumbwa kwa jinsi ya ajabu, ajabu ya kutisha. Umenipa moyo nikapendeza, umenipa uhai kila siku nacheza na ruka ruka. Siku, miezi, miaka, karne, milenia, moja, mbili, tatu. Asante Mungu, asante. Makofi kwake. Vile vile tulipoingia hapa tulikuwa tumetulia sana, kisha tukaweza kupata neno kutoka kwa kasisi. Alipokuwa akihubiri nilitafakari sana, nikaanza kufikiria ni wapi mimi nimechoka. Japo Padre akawahakikishia kwamba hakika umekuwa. Asante sana. Natumai kunao wengine pia papa hapa umewakomoa. Wapigieni makofi. Naam, ni vema na ni vizuri sana iwapo wewe utaamka kuja kutembelea kanisa nyumba ya Mwenyezi Mungu ili uweze kujiongezea imani. Najua mambo ni mengi kulijiongezea hapa ndani, najaribu vile vile hapo. Japo unapojiongea mbele ya Bwana bila shaka unaweza kupata nguvu na kuzaliwa upya. Asanteni, asanteni sana. Na papo hapo sitawasahau kuanzia kwa mkuu wao hawa walio hapa ambao vile vile wakiniheshimu, wakiniheshimu siku ya leo. Najua lengo lao ni moja tu, nalo ni kuweza kumtumikia Mwenyezi Mungu, kuyaacha yote kisha kumtumikia Mwenyezi Mungu, kama alivyotuambia na sisi kwamba huu hauji ila kwa kumtumikia Mwenyezi Mungu. Wapigie masista makofi sana. Sisi sote tumezaliwa, tuna wazazi na walifanya mengi sana katika maisha yetu. Tunajua kwamba hakuna chochote utakachomfanyia mzazi ukamlipa. Hata umpe kiasi gani hela, jamani, utamlipa. Mimi kwangu sema iwapo hata kumpa mzazi wangu chochote ni kumfanya tu atabasamu, labda waongeze miaka mingi. Wapigie wazazi wetu makofi sana. Najua wamejinyima, wamesafiri, wamechoka na kila kitu, najua hata maombi. Mimi kwangu nawaombea baraka za Mwenyezi Mungu katika kazi zenu mnazozifanya, katika tushofikile aziwazi nishiri miaka na mzidi kutulea na kutukuza kulingana na maandishi, kulingana na sifa na kulingana na mapenzi ya Mwenyezi Mungu. Asante sana wazazi wetu, asante sana kwa kutupa mabinti hao kuachilia uhuru wa kanisani ili waweze kumtumikia Mungu na kutimiza ndoto zao. Asante sana. Marafiki vile vile tumeandamana nao. Na ni vema kuwa na rafiki. Mimi naamini kwamba iwapo utaanza kutafuta Mwenyezi Mungu hapa duniani, sidhani utampata. Mwenyezi Mungu alituumba kwa mfano wake. Hivyo basi yule aliyeketi karibu na yeye ni mfano wa Mwenyezi Mungu. Bila shaka anapokutendea jamaa, unapomtendea lolote hilo zuri, unamtendea Mwenyezi Mungu. Marafiki, jamaa wote waliweza kuandamana hapa hapa wakaja kuweza kufanikisha sherehe hii. Asanteni sana. Mwenyezi Mungu awabariki na wazidishie yote mtakayohitaji. Asanteni. Wapige makofi. Kisha sisi sote tunajua kwamba sisi tulio hapa tuna jukumu la kutengeneza. Siku ya mwisho tunaulizwa, wewe uliumbwa. Kwa nini uliumbwa? Na sidhani, najua kwamba ni vigumu sana kujua kwa nini uliumbwa, lakini iwapo utafuata maandiko, iwapo utafuata dini, bila shaka utajua kwa nini uliumbwa. Iwapo utajua kwa nini uliumbwa, bila shaka hautapatikana popote pale palikuwa baya. Kama watawa wanajua uliumbwa kwa nini. Naam, na iwapo uliumbwa ukajua uliumbwa kufanya kazi gani, itekeleze pasi na kulalama kama ilivyosema sisi. Mtumwa mzuri anafanya kazi pasi na kulalama, pasi na majibuno, pasi na kusubiri ujira. Ila tu anajua fika kwamba ujira wake watoka kwa Mwenyezi Mungu. Asanteni sana kwa kusikiliza. Anayezungumza anaitwa Wafula Barasa. Asanteni.
Asanteni sana Baba Wafula. Sasa ningependa kumuita Sister Jacqueline Ocheng Onyango. For her work of thanks.
Gratitude is the memory of the heart, will ring in our hearts as one of the best motivating words of our Foundress Mother Teresa Van Miert. Our Mission Superior Sister Mary from Danina and the Mission Board, our main celebrant, Father Robert Sewe, and the co-celebrants, our deacon, our brothers and sisters, our dear parents, family members, religious men and women, and all Christians present. God is good.
All the time.
And all the time.
God is good. This is the nation of our
Mulembe Mwesi.
Mulembe Sejete.
Sejete.
Nasai Beke Dumane Kinte.
On behalf of the three of us, I would like to take this opportunity to thank the Almighty God for enabling us to live this special day in our lives. We would like to thank our General Superior, Sister Adriana Tony, in her absentia, together with the General Council, for allowing us to be part of this congregation by accepting us to have our first profession. May God bless them abundantly. To our Mission Superior, Sister Mary Rondarina, our hearts are overflowing with joy for the chance you have given us to discern God's will in the SFIC way of life. You have been and you are still a role model to us through your humble examples and loving attitude that you have for us. We thank you in a special way for granting us the chances to have new experiences that have enhanced our growth in different ways. May the Lord bless you as you remain being a star in our lives and in the lives of others. We are proud of you, sister. To our Kenya Mission Board members, we are grateful for all the support and love that you have for us throughout our formation program. May God bless you, sisters. To our main celebrant, Father Robert Sewe, thank you very much for celebrating with us and for us this Eucharistic celebration and being a witness to our first profession. We also thank the co-celebrants for participation in this celebration. May God bless you all. To our retreat master, Father Robert Sewe, we lack words of expressing our gratitude to you for your enlightenment that has sharpened our knowledge about religious life, becoming God's friends, deepening our friendship with God, growing through temptations, overcoming temptations, as part of what we shared in our retreat. This has helped us to understand the realities of the life we have embraced. Your touching examples of your own life experiences have encouraged us a lot further. We promise to use these tools as we live out our religious life. May God shower you with these blessings. Our special gratitude also goes to our dear formator, Sister Marianne. Sister, we thank you for all your tireless efforts that has brought a lot of transformation in our lives. Indeed, you have been a true mother to us. You always provided your shoulder for us to lean on whenever we worry. Your humble examples have contributed a lot in our discernment journey, as it has taught us the values of being a true religious. Your love and patience has motivated us in our vocation. May God bless you, Sister Miriam, as you continue nurturing the young sisters that have been entrusted to you. We also appreciate the sacrifice and commitment of our dear Sister Miriam and Sister Maureen for accompanying us during our retreat, for all the effort that you make to ensure that we have a conducive environment for prayer and contemplation. We thank you a lot, our beloved sisters. To our dear SFIC sisters, indeed, you have been true and exemplary sisters to us. Special thanks goes to Sister Gaudencia and Sister Anne for their sacrifice to ensure that we look beautiful today. We ask for your prayers as we journey together in this life towards God's kingdom. We will not forget to pass our sincere gratitude to our communities of San Damiano and St. Francis for welcoming us during our community experience. You not only opened for us the doors of your communities, but also the doors of your hearts. Your examples help us to understand more about fraternal life in the Franciscan context. Thank you, sisters, and may God bless you all. To our beloved parents, we would like to appreciate you in a special way for instilling in us the seed of vocation and for allowing us to respond to this call. To our brothers and sisters, relatives and friends, thank you for your countless support and prayers. We have nothing to give to you, but we promise you our prayers. Thank you very much, and may God bless you. To all religious men and women present, we thank you for sacrificing your time to come and witness our first profession. You are a special gift to us. May God bless you all. To our dear novices, postulants, and our seekers, thank you for your love, prayers, and words of encouragement. We promise you our prayers as you continue listening to God's voice. Thank you very much, dear sisters. We would like to pass our heartfelt gratitude to all the Christians from St. Cecilia's Small Christian Community. We thank you for praying with us and for us. Your deep sharing has helped us to understand more on realities of life in our contemporary world. Your words of encouragement still remain in our hearts. May you continue being a blessing to all people. To all visitors present, our lay partners, neighbors, our young Franciscan youths, and our liturgical dancers from St. Michael Parish, thank you very much, and may God bless you. Tujipigeni makofi. Asanteni sana, Erol Kamano.
Santa Miss, my ordained sisters.
Now this time they are already junior sisters. They are our youngest. May I call on Sister Mary Fondarina for the endorsement of the newly professed sisters to the junior directors, the transition from novitiate to junior.
May I request Sister Virginia Abon to please come forward and also the newly professed sisters to stand. Sister Jacqueline, Sister Lydia and Mary, I am now entrusting you to your new formator, the junior directress, who accepted the responsibility to help you in your formation as temporary professed sisters according to the rule and life and SFIC constitution. Sister Virginia Abon, I entrust to you Sister Jacqueline, Sister Lydia, and Sister Mary. Please ensure that they continue in their formation and accompany them more closely in their journey.
For the love of God, with humility and simplicity, I do accept.
It is written here that I will announce also the assignment of the three sisters. But before I will do that, I will give first my message. Because if I will give, they cannot listen anymore. They will be thinking, what did they do and where? Not the Mecca. Reverend Father Robert Sewe, our main celebrant today, and I see also here Reverend Father Vincent Shimila, and all our brothers, priests, who have concelebrated with Father, who have concelebrated today, our deacon, our seminarians, beloved parents and family members, our co-sisters and sisters Watawa Wote, and also I see here our small Christian community and neighbors and old friends. Good afternoon. Tumsipu Yesu Kristo. I will try not to repeat what have been already shared, but I will also try to be faithful to what I have prepared. Today we have many reasons for rejoicing and celebrating. One, the whole Catholic Church all over the world celebrates the solemnity of the Immaculate Conception of the Blessed Virgin Mary, our Mother, who asserts that the Blessed Virgin Mary, from the first moment of her conception, was preserved free from every stain of original sin. This doctrine of the Catholic Church was proclaimed by Pope Pius IX on 8th December 1854. The two Franciscan theologians, William of Vare and Blessed John Duns Scotus, who developed this theology, pointed out that Mary's Immaculate Conception enhances Jesus' redemptive work. For us, we are cleansed from original sin after our birth during baptism. But in Mary, Jesus' work was so powerful as to prevent original sin at the outset. So Pope Pius IX gave this infallible statement, and I quote, "The Most Blessed Virgin Mary, in the first instant of her conception, by a singular grace and privilege granted by the Almighty God in view of the merits of Jesus Christ, the Savior of the human race, was preserved free from all stain of original sin. 2, it is also our big feast of the congregation, we bear in our name two most important realities in the person of Mary, that is her Immaculate Conception and Mother of God. So that's why we have very long name, Franciscan Sisters of the Immaculate Conception of the Holy Mother of God. As a congregation, we honor Mary, the patroness of our congregation, as a woman who always did the will of the Father. Mary, who gave us example of prayerful searchings and discerning on how to be of service to God and others by her openness to obey God's will, is the model for all of us and for those who wish to follow Christ perfectly. In our daily lives, we are happy, successful, challenged, and also with problems. And in times of difficulties, we run to Mary, who is full of grace and free of sin, because we experience in our daily life that her holiness and her protection mirrors the goodness and compassion of our God. Thirdly, we are also celebrating and praising God for our newly professed sisters. They are here in front of us. Father Robert explained very clearly what the vows are and what are its implications and demands from all of us, sisters. I hope that we have understood, and I know that we have understood, even our parents and family members and visitors have understood what it means and what it entails. So after this profession of first temporary vows, what is next? Therefore, it is not the end of again, but it is again a new beginning for our sisters. These three sisters are now called temporary professed sisters. Today, they profess only for 1 year. So they are given a year of continuous discernment and trying to live the vows that they have committed. And they will do this renewal for 6 to 9 years every year. So formation continues until they reach a time when they are ready or sure of themselves, or the congregation see them fit and able to live the spirit and charism of the congregation. So there is a process of continuous discernment on the part of the sister. And at the same time also, not only them, but also the congregation, the professed sisters represented by the formator, the leadership, and the perpetually professed sisters. The sister need to progressively grow into maturity in all aspect of religious life. However, even if a sister does not renew her vows and decide and leaves and go back home, she will not lose anything because she had undergone a formation which made her more mature, wiser, deeper in faith and love. We will learn and understand that life which is called religious life is not easy. It is demanding a lot from each one of us. But also the inner joy which God gives us is unsurpassable. We will give that for the sisters who profess, you have signed in a life of penance. Remember, sisters, our congregation is a penitent congregation. We promise to live a life of penance. ongoing conversion according to the life which our Father Saint Francis of Assisi had taught us. And for our beloved parents and family members of the three sisters, thank you very much for offering your daughter to God, to serve Him in many different ways. With this act of offering, you will be blessed and rewarded 100-fold by our God, not only in this life, but in the life to come. I would like to thank all our visitors. I would not like to mention names because I may miss one. So our visitors here, our friends, our neighbors, members of our small Christian community also in this area are here, and other friends, our lay partners, co and sisters also. Thank you very much for joining up with us for this celebration. Congratulations, dear sisters, Mary, Lydia, and Jacqueline. We ask Mary, our mother, for her protection and guidance, so that your life and ours may be a mirror of God's goodness and love for others. We pray also that we may always be ready to proclaim, as she proclaimed, I am the handmaid of the Lord, let it be done to me as you have said, in words and in deeds. Dear sisters, let us celebrate the richness of our spirit and charism, our vitality, our values, and our loving service to God's people. And now I will announce the assignment of the sisters. For Sister Jacqueline, she will be assigned to Mother Teresa Vermeer Community, Nairobi. Sister Mary will go to St. Francis Community, Uyugis. And for Sister Lydia, she will go to Mother Teresa Vermeer, Nairobi. Again, Sante Nisana, thank you very much. And may God bless us all.
Thank you very much, Sister Mary. I'm sorry, German. Now, before we go to the concluding rite, I'd like to introduce our brother priests and brothers. Okay? So I would like to start with this.
Thank you, Sister Beth. Makofi kwa sister. Mungu ni mwema.
Kila wakati.
Salamiane. Mungu ni mwema.
Kila wakati.
Kila wakati. Ni siku ya kipekee kabisa. Siku hii hapa kushuhudia dada zetu watatu weka nadhiri zao za mwanzo. Ni siku ya baraka kubwa hasa kwetu ambao tumewajua wakiwa wadogo sasa ni wakubwa. Makofi kwangu. Ndio kipekee na mwakilisha baba paroko wa Konongolo ule kwetu ambao Sister Lydia ametoka. Ilipokuwa anapata ordination 13 years ago, Sister Lydia alikuwa PMC. Makofi kwake. Alikuwa na danzi kama wale wasichana walipokuwa na danzi hapa leo. Lakini leo sio PMC tena, ni sister. Kwa hivyo ni pongezi kubwa sister. Na Waingereza wanasema a cheek that grows in the cock is seen the very day it hatches. Sawa sawa. Kwa hivyo unaweza kujua tu huyu mwelekeo wake unaenda wapi. Kwa hivyo kwa niaba ya parokia yetu nasema asante kwa Mwenyezi Mungu na kwa masista hao kumpokea dada yetu pamoja na dada hao wengine wawili kuweza kuweka nadhiri hii. Mungu awajalie neema waweze kuishi jinsi walivyoahidi. Tumsifu Yesu Kristo. Amen. Naitwa Father Vincent Chumila, mimi ni ndugu yao. Kapchili. Asante.
God is good.
And
all the time. I wish to register that I'm here wearing a pair of shoes. Wearing a pair of shoes. One shoes is on behalf of the family members. Another one on behalf of my parish priest. Sister Jacqueline is my cousin. And in fact, when she thought of joining, she came to visit us at our community there in Kisima, Karen. Then I think she saw how we lived. Then after 1 week, she was inspired. Then through the help of Sister Maureen, we called them, things worked out, and now she can smile in white clothing. And so congratulations, Sister Jackie, and also the family members. Are you there? Can I see you? Yes, karibuni sana Nairobi, Macheli ni Uhuru. On behalf of my parish priest, Father Moses Ochieng, receive congratulations from him. He was unable to come, but I was with him yesterday as Peter. I traveled yesterday night and arrived this morning, and he sends greetings to you and to everyone here present, and is waiting for you. I'm told that you are in Nairobi, but I think we are also waiting for you at Beta, because peace, kuna mambo hapo, the goes of next week. So karibu sana, na my sister wote, karibu sana. Kwa majina, naitwa Morris Kings, alia padile. Asante sana.
Tumsifu Yesu Kristo.
Milele
amina.
Tumsifu Yesu Kristo.
Na Father Henry Ouko, Passionist, Missionary, working in Moloko Mission House. Congratulations.
Tumsifu
Yesu Kristo.
Milele
amina. Mimi ni Father James Kumba. Na pia nashirikiana na kila mmoja kupongeza masista hawa ambao leo wamechukua nadhiri ya kuwa watumishi katika kanisa. Nashukuru wanashirika wenzake kiongozwa na Sister Meli Rondelina ambaye amekuwa mfano mzuri na akiwa mlezi wa hawa. Pia sister huyu alikuwa mlezi wetu tukiwa vijana wadogo. Walikuwa masista wachache sana. Walikuwa masista wachache sana. Walikuwa masista kama 4, 5, 6 hivi. Lakini sasa ukiangalia shirika linakuwa umekuwa masista zaidi ya 30 tangu. Kwa hiyo mimi nashukuru sister kwa kazi nzuri of touching minds of young people and inviting them to the religious life. Barikiwe sana.
Ninaitwa the Patrick Kijungu, Homa Bay, Jimbo la Homa Bay. Hawa masista wakuna kumitu mbili, pano kia mbili, mojo yugis, mengine kiacha. Na nimekuwa, nimeishi nao kiacha, zaidi ya mwaka moja, kama yugis, zaidi ya mwaka mbili. Kwa hivyo ni kama nilikuwa moja ya familia yao. Kwa hivyo kama wako na sherehe, mimi nilikuja tu, nilikuwa nauliza pande moja, wanafanya sherehe gani? Mimi nilisikia tu sherehe, nikasema waje nikuje. Haya mwingine anafuata baadaye. Kwa hivyo hongera kwa sisa na hongera pia kwa kuwa. Thank you, may God bless you.
Tumsifu Yesu Kristo.
Milele
amina. Daima na milele.
Tumsifu Yesu Kristo.
Kwa majina naitwa Eric Michura, Passionist Missionaries, working together with Father Henry in the Formation House, that's Molo. Congratulations and may God bless you all.
God is good.
All the time.
All the time.
God is good.
I don't know why I came to this community. I've been asking a question. But what I know is my mother is behind there. She is my godmother. I was a member of this small Christian community, very active with my sisters. I'm a spiritual from Madagascar. My name is Randy Amanesi Paul Sembeni. That's why I'm very happy to get it soon. I'm very happy to be part of this celebration and also to be part of the small Christian community. This celebration reminded me in 2013 when I took my first profession in Moses Island, and then the sister was telling about where to go, and then I was shaking as I saw them, they were just quiet, and then where to go, and then the supia came, and then Paul, you are going to Kenya for 2 years of pastoral. And then, I did not know even English. I don't know what is the language to speak apart from English in the country. But when I came here, I learned English. And then I continued my formation, theology at Tangaza. But for good, but I don't know if it is good or bad. I'm going back to Kenya for mission after my priestly ordination next year. But so it means that I'm a part of Kenya. I'm becoming a Kenyan in 6 years now. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Pastor.
Thank you.
Yes. Amana salam. Jina ni Brother Ruben Kemei na nasoma theolojia Tangaza, ndugu Mkapuchini. Kwa masista hongereni sana na Mungu wabariki katika maisha utawa.
Mpadre wetu, ndugu, masista na Wakristo kwa jumla, tumsifu Yesu Kristo. Jina langu ni Douglas Wanjala, kwa nyinyi, Mkapuchini, somo la shule ya Tangaza. Asante.
God is good.
All the time.
And all the time.
God is good.
Allow me to begin by saying that the whole protocol observed. And after saying that, I know at this particular time, wisdom does not only require but demands that we should not speak too much. But allow me also to congratulate, join my brothers in congratulating the sisters, but allow me also to say one thing, the word of Cyril, the Cyril, Saint Cyril, Alexander, of Alexander, the bishop, when he was defending the dogmatic theology of what we are celebrating today, the Immaculate Conception. He said that no one can build his house to completion, then allow the enemy to stay in it. He was defending Mary, that there is no way God can create Mary and define her, finally to allow the devil to stay in her. Instead, he prepared the way for his son to come and stay in her. You have been prepared. And now is your time also to give back to the Lord. May God bless you. Thank you.
Thank you. By the name of Kuru Ochogodona, Mr. Kapuchi from Uganda.
Asanteni sana, mapadri na mabruda. Sasa ningependa pia ku recognize the presence of our new sisters who are here. May I just ask you to wave your hand. the Evangelizing Sisters of Mary, Santeni, the LaSalle Brothers, thank you, and the Severian Brothers, and our brothers and sisters from Kitale. Thank you very much, Santeni Sana. And also from Bongoma, the Fadari Simameni. Also our Wakristu Wote Kutok Mbita, Mbita Homa Bay Diocese. The Fadari Simameni. Ero Kamano Mabeer. Ero Kamano. Morio Mano. Morio Mano. Asante Nisana. Alapo, I would like also to thank the presence of our mission partners, Simameni Tufadali, John, Sami, Wilson Tufadali, Simameni, Asante Nisana. Alapo, our organists from St. Michael Paris, Asante, from Kuria, Mbuya Moyere. Of course, our faithful brother photographer, Boys Department, SFIC. Asante, Asante Sana. And also, our I would like to recognize the presence of our aspirant, I mean, searchers from Tanzania. Thank you very much for coming and joining us in this celebration. And also our SFIC sisters who have been working day and night, cooking, preparing, cleaning, and everything. Our celebration, you can see how beautiful, and you will also taste the food from the kitchen. I would like, and all the decorations, may I ask our sisters, junior sisters, the novices, and the postulants to please stand up. Thank you very much, and I think all of us have contributed for the success of this celebration. I think I have nothing. Of course, our neighbors, yes, our neighbors, please. Mama Elizabeth, please. Simame Mama Efatali from the Christian communities. Asante Sana. Okay, God bless you all. And of course, I would like to give some announcement. After the blessing of our brother celebrant, on behalf of the SFIC, I'm inviting you to join us in our simple food that has been prepared by our sisters and all the parents, and together with our young newly professed, to please assist them to go to the hall, as well as our brother priests. I would like you just to stay here, and then the Aserets will help you where to go. We are all invited to celebrate our simple lunch. Thank you very much, and may God bless you. May I invite now our celebrant to end our Eucharistic celebration.
God is good at all the
times.
I talked much already, and according to the advice of my brother Opio, I will not add anything more. Just to register my happiness. My happiness, and say, I've now been coming here for the past 3 years, and this is a well a daily celebration, especially at the altar here. I'm very happy to have these great people like Shumila. They are rare people to see around. Father Kumba. I was working with Father Kumba in Homa Bay, number 3 after the bishop. So it's not just a simple man to see. And I'm happy to see Father Gates and Father Henry and Father Jura and Father Dungu. He took us to the mountain there. Very, very happy. And to see people of Kimwaka Parish, I came there, I welcomed as well. Tulikula vizuri sana kwa Kimwaka. Tulipokuja kwa sherehe ya Father Moses. Asanteni sana. Parokia St. Andrew. Pia tulikula vizuri. Wakati ulikuwa mtagawanyika. Tulipokuja kwa sherehe ya Father Shumila. Na watu wa Mbita. Asanteni sana. Tulisha vizuri sana.
Been found worthy to receive the order of life.
Amen.
May you who have devoutly gathered on this day carry away with you the gifts of spiritual joys and heavenly rewards. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Thank you. cutting.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.